I'm habitual in my positive thinking. Rule number one, you must always pay attention to your emotional state. Here is what the homie Abraham would call the emotional guidance system. See, what I do is I make sure I always go to sleep around green. I make sure I go to sleep around this. That way I can wake up and affirm to this side, and then my family will bring me up here. And then it's my goal as a habitual positive thinker to have thoughts that keep me in this vibration. But yesterday, I fell. Now, yesterday, I found myself hit worry, then anger, then guilt. So now, as a habitual positive thinker, it's my job to control the thoughts to push me back up. So I know I can't go from guilt to love. So I have to guide myself through my emotions. So by time I go to sleep, I'm back at green. And then you start to find yourself being grateful to be bored. Grateful that your son just irritated you. Now you're like, okay, I'm back up there. Let me keep moving it. That's all you gotta do. And move it up there. And then make sure you go to sleep around green. That's it. And it'll be easy for you to wake up and affirm yourself in the blue, and then use your surroundings to keep you around purple.
But you weren't here. You're not here to be normal. You're just here to shine. You're here to be abnormal. You're here to lead by example. It's time. Let's go, folks. Let's go. I love you.
We have all been taught that the brain is the master organ in the human body, but new studies show that the heart is where the brain gets its signals from. These two organs work together Wow. in harmony as a single potential system that allows us to self-regulate like no other life on this planet. Mm-hmm. The heart is literally 100 times stronger magnetically than the brain. Thus, meaning feelings are much more magnetic than thoughts. So when you're using your heart to feel, it will attract what you want to obtain in the quantum field.
This is definitely one of my favorite passages on manifesting. Listen. When you decide to observe a future in the quantum field that you want to manifest, if you're doing it as a victim or someone who's suffering or feeling limited or unhappy, your energy is not going to be consistent with your intended creation, and you won't be able to call that new future to yourself. That's the past. You may have a clear intention, and therefore your mind may be in the future because you can imagine what you want, but if you feel any of those familiar limited emotions, your body still believes it's in the same limited past experiences. So, if you want to create change, you have to do it from a level of energy that's greater than guilt, greater than pain, greater than fear, greater than anger, greater than shame, and greater than unworthiness. If you are going to perform something that's unlimited, you'd better feel unlimited. If you want to create freedom, you'd better feel free. And if you want to truly heal yourself, you'd better raise your energy to wholeness. The more elevated the emotion you feel, the greater the energy you broadcast, and the more influence you will have on the material world.
Because you now realize you're not afraid anymore. You now realize fear is the only way they can control you. Fear is the only way they can control you. And they are afraid of love because love creates a world they cannot control. And when we talk of the final days, I told you, people are going to switch sides. Celebrities are going to say, hey, just go along with the system. So right now, in the final days, you better know thyself. You better know who you really are. Because even your own family members, friends, they're going to lure you back into the matrix. To see.
Dear Everett.
I often wondered why the news is always showing fear-based stories. 10 people dead here. Be afraid of this. Be afraid of that. And I realize it's because they want people to live in a perpetual state of fear. You see, when you are living in fear, you become conditioned. And this is why a lot of people who are very fearful, they swear by the truth they have. They never want to question. They're just like, I heard it on the news. Yes, it's the right thing to do. Someone told me. I'm scared. I'm very scared. But you see, love is open. It's neutral. It's not about agreeing or disagreeing. It's about seeing something for what it is. And this is how
you have superpowers that you're not aware of.
Everyone on the planet has the ability to magnetically attract what they want into their life.
Whatever you think and feel naturally becomes your reality.
We are constantly creating our own reality, whether we are conscious of it or not. Everything on the planet vibrates at a certain frequency. As your frequency begins to vibrate higher, you're going to experience thoughts and emotions that are contained within that frequency. So if you're vibrating within a frequency of love, you're going to experience loving thoughts and emotions.
According to research from Harvard, human beings are basically walking energetic magnets. Around your body, there exist two magnetic fields, a smaller one and a larger one. They are commonly known as a torus, and they're the magnetic fields of your heart.
We all know the principle of physics where like attracts like. Whatever your field is vibrating at is what will naturally come into your field. So this means the higher your heart vibrates, the more your field expands. And so the more your field expands and the bigger it is, you are able to attract abundance so much easier.
As Einstein said, everything is energy. That's all there is to it. Match the frequency of the reality you want to attract, and you cannot help but get that reality.
This is not philosophy. This is physics.
Crossing the river of change, going from the old self to the new self, requires you stepping into the unknown. And if you are now in the unknown and you feel uncomfortable because you're leaving guilt behind, you leave unworthiness behind. You see, the biggest problem with most people is they want to create wealth, but they feel lack. They want a new life, but they feel unworthy. That's mind.
70% of the time, people live in stress, and living in stress is living in survival. Now, all organisms in nature can tolerate short-term stress. You know, a deer gets chased by a pack of coyotes. When it outruns the coyotes, it goes back to grazing, and the event is over. So you're driving down the road, someone cuts you off, you jam on the brakes, you may give them the finger, and then you settle back down, and the event is over, and boom, now everything's back to normal. When you turn on the stress response and you can't turn it off, now you're headed for disease, because no organism in nature can live in emergency mode for that extended period of time. It's a scientific fact that the hormones of stress downregulate genes and create disease, long-term effects. That means then our thoughts could make us sick. So if it's possible that our thoughts could make us sick, is it possible then our thoughts could make us well? The answer is absolutely yes.
Everyone in this room knows how to create. You're not a manager of your life. You're a creator of your life, or you wouldn't be in this room. How do you create your life? You get hungry for something, don't you? Who has done something in your life that once seemed difficult or impossible, and now it's part of your life? How did you do it? You created it. You decided there's something you wanted so bad that you unleashed all your desire. You became obsessed with it. If it was a business or a car or a relationship or a transformation in your body. If there's something you once envisioned and now it's real, it's because you didn't just envision it. You brought so much emotion to it that now it's in your life. It was once a dream. It was once a goal. And now it's in your life.
What people know is the emotion is created by motion. The way you move determines the way you feel. I have this deal with myself called priming. Every day, I say, look, you got to have 10 minutes for yourself. If you don't have 10 minutes for yourself, you don't have a life. 10 minutes, I put some music on. I do this massive change in my breathing, so it radically changes the way I feel. And then I do this three-step process. First, I do 3 minutes of gratitude, where I think of three things I'm really grateful for, and I associate. I don't think of it over there. I feel it. When you're grateful, you can't be worried. You can't be fearful. You can't be angry. And then I do a three-minute process of kind of a prayer for my family and friends, and then I do a three-minute process of the top three things I want to accomplish. I see it as done, and I feel I'm done in 10 minutes. So sometimes I go 20.
Everything is energy. And you come to Earth to learn how to manipulate that, to be a master manifester. So once you learn how to manipulate energy, you can have anything you want. Nothing is impossible. There are no limitations except the limitations you put upon yourself.
So you say you wanna get away. We don't need a plane. I could be your escape.